Hello and welcome to the show. Today I'm going to be taking a look at some of the racing on Burnout 3. So I played through the crash mode on this game. It was an awful lot of fun messing about with the crash. But I'm going to have a go at some of the racing events. Because, you know, there's an awful lot to this game. And I haven't actually done proper serious racing. Well, I say serious racing. As serious as Burnout gets. Kind of actual, you know, sort of proper driving. If we can get across to where we're supposed to be going. Yes, we shall go and do a race. I think I've done a couple of these when I first loaded up the game, just to make sure everything was all working. What car should we use? It's weird having a choice of vehicles. They're all pretty much the same, except for that one there's less weight. So, sure, we'll go with this one here. After all of my playing of the crash mode, it's weird to actually give me an option of cars to use for an event. From my experiences, from me remembering, beat the rival to win the car. Basically, how this tends to work is you crash the opponents off the road. And you kind of don't really pay much attention to actual racing. Because the takedowns were so fun on here, that actually doing proper racing was, you know, it kind of came second to just crashing your opponent off the track. Come back here! I want to put your car in a wall. It's also made racing a lot easier, because you didn't actually have to do particularly well. You could just smack him into the wall. where has he gone? Oh, hello. He's right there. No! You're not allowed to play this game with me. You crashed into a car. Oh, bugger me. I nearly did the same. That's not a handbrake. I don't know if it is actually a handbrake on here. Right, I've completely forgotten all of my Burnout driving experience. Car's coming across the junction. Bus! No! Why did you do that, you stupid, stupid bus? God damn it. Now, that's a poor... Oh, hello. That's a poor... I've managed to turn the bus British, I think. things may not have gone too well in all of that. I'm 5 seconds behind. Quick, let me catch up. Is rubber banding almost as bad as Need for Speeds? Almost. he didn't crash into the... He didn't wreck from the van. That's disappointing. Whoa. No, we're going to either side of the taxi. Right, you go in the wall. Did you go in the wall? Oh, okay, fine. Go over that way then. I don't know where he's gone anymore. Let's just kind of fire the car across the road. See where he's going. He's right on my tail. I don't see... Oh, he's somewhere. He's like side by side with me. Oh, hello. Yeah, he definitely gave me a nudge. Whoop, he's in space as well. Okay. Oh, no. There's a van there. We nearly met our doom at the front of a van. I have no idea where this track is going or how... The lap seemed quite... Oh, it's only a one-lap race. That's why laps seemed quite long. As I say, these laps seem to be taking a while. But, okay, that would explain it. And we slide our way down here. Just about slide our way down here. I forgot how good the handling was for these. Yeah, but the cars do feel quite heavy. Sure, you know, it's very, very much an arcade game. The cars feel heavy. Oh, don't change lanes like that, you moron. They feel a lot heavier than they did on Burnout Paradise. I will say that much. They do feel heavier, but they still feel responsive. It just takes a little bit more to get them to do quite what you want. Yay, all of the records. Look at me go. Two new cars. Two cars unlocked. Look at that. Fantastic. What a glorious start to my racing on here. I'm assuming we've still got stuff. I'm assuming we're still unlocking stuff, sorry, in the compact class. Right, that's the car that we just beat. Modified compact. Yeah, okay. I will take that one. And for getting 4 gold medals, we have got a car that we can't use yet because it's probably for a later series, but awesome. Okay, I don't know, never mind, I lied. Apparently that's a compact as well. That's a bit bigger, compact DX. Okay, it kind of looks like a full-size car has been cut down to make it to a compact, sort of, into that class. It looks like it should be a lot longer, but never mind. Ah, okay, so we get points in this. So it kind of works a similar way to the crash tour, and it's, we're gaining points for doing stuff. Oh, and takedowns, of course. God, there is so many cars to unlock and so much to be done. I've unlocked a special event, apparently. Sure. It's just all of the unlocks so far, it seems. You're invited to a special event in the Far East. Okay, what are we doing over here? I can't remember at all how the career mode works. I can't quite like the way that this is structured, though. Oh, bloody hell, this is going to be quick. Super Series. Sure, let's cause mayhem and wreck everything. No, not wreck myself. That's likely to be the most thing that's going to happen. That English was awful. I do apologise. My brain is giving up at the moment. Ah, we have a time trial. Yes, of course. I was never very good at these, if I remembered correctly. Was there one with a... the Formula One car that was horrible? I can't remember. I know there are some of these. Oh, crap, this is all oncoming traffic. Of course, because we're in Japan and they drive on the other side of the road. I'm so used to driving in America in games. Okay, we didn't quite like that transition. I don't know why I keep going for X. Is there actually a handbrake on this game? I don't know if there is. I keep going for X thinking. I think it's just tap brake. But never mind. Right, speed down here. Oh, this is where we can have a monumental accident if we're not careful. There we go. Look at that. We're probably going to have to be on the boost a lot if we want to get a gold medal for this. Ah! That's not where we wanted to go. I didn't quite know where we were going. I may have made a mess of everything slightly. I'm not playing... I've got to get it out of my brain. We're not playing crash events. Yeah, I think I should have probably been on boost a lot more around here. These events are definitely challenging. We'll run the wall. It's fine. It's fine. Where are we going now? So you'll recognise all of these bits from the crash junctions, because the crash junctions are just taken from their normal circuit. We're kind of wiggling and weaving our way down the road. Hey, there we go. Slightly bouncing off a wall. I've not done a very good job of driving on this one. I've, again, forgotten all of my burnout speed techniques. We slightly bounced off a wall. I mean, it was okay-ish. I'm guessing I have to get a gold. I will try one more. I do remember these being insanely difficult. I will try again. If we don't smack it in a wall and I use the boost as much as I'm supposed to, it's pretty much just stay in this lane, accumulate boost, and then we'll go for it. I think if I'm in oncoming traffic... Oh, I can hold down the boost and I'm actually gaining it. So we gain it faster than we use it. Oh, if we're in oncoming traffic. Okay, let's maybe not play it that risky. Oh, Christ. Okay, no, wait. The wall saved us. The wall was actually useful. Oh, good God. The speeds that we are trying to navigate the city at the... It's ridiculous. And this is why I love Burnout. Because you're trying to navigate the city flat out at 200 miles an hour. And he goes, yeah, we've got all the grip in the world for doing this sort of thing. That's a car. Don't weave too much. Don't weave too much. It's just pure guesswork almost. Where are the cars going to be? Pray they're not directly in front of you. So far, I don't think I've let off the boost since I fired it. We are getting a little lucky with these sort of grinds along the wall. They are kind of, letting us get away with lots. The little bumps across the grass that fire your car up into the air, they're never fun. Oh, we're going to nail that one. I thought it was in the second of the two lanes. Oopsie! We've slightly murdered everything. Ah, we were on for a gold medal. If I'd kept that together, probably would have got it, because it's just here. Damn it. God, that is fast. That is so fast you have to do that. My brain is not quite prepared. I want to go for a gold medal now. My brain is so used to normal racing games, it's not quite prepared. I don't even think Paradise has these ridiculous sort of... There are kind of time trial-y stuff in Paradise, but I mean, this is literally, you have to do the whole thing at 200 miles an hour if you want to get a gold medal. Oh, we're going to nail that thing. Okay, one more go. It's addicting trying to do this, because you literally got to do the run perfect if you want a gold medal. I think there may be the odd one that you might get away with, like, one accident, possibly, like, really arsey ones, but this one here is only a minute 13 lap, so it's like, yep, you must do perfection if you want to get a gold medal, and that's kind of how it should be. It's just annoying when said perfection is, or when it wants you to do, like, a 5 minute lap perfect. Like, no, that's not really going to happen, that's going to end. Okay, no, the game is, it's quite forgiving with the whole brushing off the walls. If it wanted me to do this at flat out on boost the whole time, and if I scraped a wall, I'd crash, or I would wreck, you should say. That would be a bit difficult. As it is, it's pretty nice. Oh, I couldn't quite get it to sort of counter that drift in time. I don't know if the traffic is fixed or not. I can't decide if it... Yeah, I think it might be traffic's in a set place on the around the lap. It kind of works in my favour, really. I haven't got that transition there right whatsoever. I could definitely save some time if I did that right. I did that definitely wrong. So much better last time around. But you don't really lose that much time from bouncing off the wall. I think you'll lose a little bit of momentum. Right, so don't try and go out the inside. Yeah, it tricks you into thinking that the car there is on the in the second lane, so I thought there's going to be a gap to fire myself up, and there most definitely was not. Right, are we going to cross the finish line? We are going to do it. Okay, it wasn't quite perfection, I will be honest on that run. I got a few bounces off the wall, so you'd probably go a bit quicker. Whoa, I forgot how fast those burning laps were. That's fast. You need full concentration if you want to make it around there. Fortunately, the traffic isn't too heavy, but Yay, we got an event postcard. I assume if you collect all of these, you unlock special cars. There's all sorts of unlocks to get in this game. Right, we've got some more burnout points. Okay, back to USA. Where were we? Where are the road rage events? Road rage events are the most amazing things ever. They really are. Please let me have some unlocked. That's just a face-off. Please have a road rage event. Over here. Come on. What a road rage. Oh, it's only races. How do we unlock you? I've got to get to the muscle series. Maybe there aren't any... Oh, that's this. Oh wait, there is a road rage. I've apparently done it. This might be when I was testing it. I ended up doing it. Right. Got to have a go with the road rage. So, what car are we going to use? We've got the custom one. We've got the... we've got the modified one. We've got the custom one. I think we had the DX. There we go. Yeah, down here. There's quite a lot of vehicles to choose from. There's however many there are in this category, and this is just one category, and there's quite a few different. Sure, we'll go for a red one. Okay, road rage is all about trying to get down as many, or get as many takedowns as you can within a set time limit. Now, I can't remember quite how it works on Burnout 3, if every takedown extends your time, or whether it is just 3 minutes that we have to gather takedowns. In Paradise, getting takedowns extends your time, so you can sort of go on almost indefinitely if you're really, really good. We all wrecked each other. I thought I could get away with putting him in the wall, and then that's not worked at all in my favour. that was terrible, terrible driving. I thought I could get him in the wall, and I would be okay with bouncing off it, but apparently not. Right, you can go in the back of a taxi. Fantastic. Okay, that's one down. I don't think it does increase my time. Okay, so we can't do this indefinitely. Careful now. I can't remember what my record is in Paradise. I think I got about 40 or 50 takedowns. There was a... Okay, no, that's not quite how I want things to happen. There was a road that you could go to. If you try to do takedowns in the city, it never really worked. But you go out on the country roads and you could get so many. You could just constantly... okay, now we're all just bumping doors. You're going up there. Yes, to space with you. If you went on the country roads... little glitchy there. got a little stuck on the pillar. If you went to the country roads on Paradise to do the takedowns, because of the kind of the nature of the roads and the way the AI sort of respawned and appeared and so on, you could get so many takedowns in quick succession. You could keep the time rolling. I think I got another takedown in that cutscene. I think you saw the car go into the front of the van there. Yeah, takedowns or road rage, as they call it, amazing fun. Whee! Attack the office building with you. You can find a van. Oh, you survived the van. You found it, but you survived it. No, you're going to put me in attack. I was hoping that it was going to be him that hit the taxi and the AI would take control of my car in time so that I could avoid said taxi. But no, that does not work like that. Right, use the nitro. Can we fire you into something? The AI are actually pretty good at putting me in the back of a taxi, it seems. Oh, we got murdered by a van. The AI are very, very feisty, it seems, today. They are not putting up for me bullying them whatsoever. Why are you going down... I was seeing why the AI suddenly vanished down there. Don't start bullying me now. This is not going at all well for me. I'm actually surprised. I would have thought my car would have been dead by now. You can only get taken out so many times before it will fail or it will end the level. That's what I thought. Right, I'm bringing the wreck. I think I put the wreck into the back of another car. I'm not actually sure what I quite did there. You can have a huge boost shunt. There we go. You've found some trees. Oh, it's often quite scary retaking control of your car after it's gone through the cutscene, because you're never quite sure where your car's going to be ending up. Oh, come on. I want to get a good kind of chain going on of getting takedowns. If you get it right, you can do really good chains of takedowns where you kind of bounce from side to side, taking out all of the cars around you. I've just not quite got that going on yet. Right, there goes one. If I can retake control of my car, can we get another? Ooh! I think we got another, but it's not really my doing. That was cross traffic and a slight nudge from me at one point. Right, you go into the... Oh, you're fighting back there. You go into the wall. Oh, I've compromised myself. No, it's fine. It's fine. I thought that was going to be game over. I hate that turn so much. It's such a horrible turn. We're all wrecked. No, with the respawn. It's such a horrible turn trying to navigate the pillars, especially when you're all nudging each other about. Hey, 11 takedowns. That wasn't fantastic. Oh, I got two cars unlocked, though, which I'll take. Oh, I guess I got the takedown number high enough, didn't I? I think I was pretty close to it. Awesome. Right, what have we got? Ah, we got burnout points and takedowns to the required number. Oh, what have we got? That looks like a muscle car of some sorts. Is it yet custom muscle car? Awesome. Right, so we will have a few more vehicles. You always have two vehicles unlocked in every category, I believe. Hey, we've got the takedowns. And then you unlock others by completing races and by completing the targets. Completing, there we go. I've got there eventually. And that looks like another compact, assassin compact. Awesome. Right. I'm guessing you'll probably get special cars for completing all of that stuff as well. Right, oh, the aftertouch takedowns, I completely forgot about them. Yeah, when you crash, you can go into the impact time mode, there we go, that's what it's called, and move around, and if there are cars racing about, you can cause them to have an accident as well. Sure, let's have a go in this. I mean, most of these are pretty much of a muchness between them. Most of these have got exactly the same top speed and weight. I think when you get to the higher categories, it makes more of a difference between the two vehicles. You kind of want as heavy a vehicle as possible when you're doing the takedown stuff, so you don't get pushed around as much. Look, we can have sunset without it being completely and utterly blinding. Ah, that looks like the Dominator compact car. Can you please bugger off? Please bugger off. Where are you? In fact, actually, no, come side by side, and I'll put you in the wall. There we go. You can bugger off to space. I will take that, and now I shall run away with the lead. For briefly, he'll respawn and he'll be right behind me. That's just the way Burnout is. Otherwise, you just do one takedown and you would win the race, provided you don't crash, of course. So yeah, there is kind of quite extreme rubber banding going on here. But you kind of don't mind it that much because you just have fun and bully the AIs about. Careful now. Yep, there we go. He's back again. I'm not sure. I can't remember what game I'm thinking of. Maybe it's an earlier Burnout where you could, like, wreck opponents, like, for good. So if you take them out enough times, they're wrecked for good. I don't remember what game that is. I was thinking it was Burnout, but I'm not sure it is. I know it's from the road rage mode, but don't know what other arcade racing game I might have been playing that had that. Oh, look at that. We were almost tandeming briefly around that hairpin. Oh, bloody hell, where are we going? I kind of want an emergency handbrake when I realised a corner is a little tighter than than I expected it to be. Yep, that's two. Two times you've been put upside down. Again, I'm guessing this is only one lap, or is this a point-to-point race? It could be. It doesn't seem to. It just says I am in position one of two. Whee! And we're doing a little bit of snaking down the road. Avoid the bus. Oh dear. I'm 4 seconds ahead and he's right on my tail, apparently. Not sure about that game. Are you sure you can maths? I mean, I know I can't maths, but are you sure you can maths? Where has he gone? I think he's on he's in oncoming traffic, which is always a scary idea to be doing in Burnout. Apparently he's right behind me, so I'm guessing he's right alongside in the other lane. Oh, there goes the back end. Just a little bit as I try to change direction. Yeah, some of the, especially the more powerful cars, you will have the back end step out on you from time to time. Normally it's just a tap the handbrake and you will go sliding around. And it's a great arcadey handling system, Burnout. Burnout's always had really, really good handling. Yes, he went in the truck. Well done. Oh, crap, let me have control of my car before we end up in a wall. Now we're in oncoming traffic again. Uh-oh. Oncoming traffic is good for boosting. Fantastic for boosting. Okay, now we're going over here. In fact, the car decided we were going over there. It started sliding. I didn't really have much of a choice in the matter. We were heading this way regardless. We'll just hold the boost down and do 160 down the motorway. Where is he? He's buggered off. He's not right behind me. I can't see him. Let's see. He's miles behind. Where do we finish as well? I don't know. This has been a pretty good tour. Holy crap. With the sudden sliding car. Finished. I don't know where he is at all. Yeah, we completely and utterly lost him. Longest drift. There he is. Well done. Yes, I heard the crash. I heard the crash on that one. What a moron. Hey, we've unlocked the Dominator compact. Right, to finish this up, I might as well go do the final. I think there was one more race, but I might as well do like the GP thing. I think this is like the finale for the compact cars. I can't remember if it. I think when we come back around, I think it's got a similar system to the crash tour where you'll do multiple laps around the world. But we'll come back and we'll probably be using a different class of car. So we'll be at muscle cars or whatever it is. So we will do the compact Grand Prix. Now, if I remembered rightly, this is kind of like over a. Sure, we'll go for the fiery one. This is over like multiple events, so you'll score points for coming first, second, third, or whatever. And we'll have probably like a time trial and a race and a road rage, perhaps. At least that's what I'm kind of expecting, unless my memory is awful. Okay, maybe it's just a race series, so we've just got to complete the races. Right, two laps. How many times can I wreck my opponents in the two laps? No, don't put me in a bus. Thank you. Hey, I got a signature takedown. Again, there's things to collect, but there's all of these different signature takedowns, so you've got to cause the cars to crash in specific ways. So that one was hit a motorhome, and there'll probably be ones for hitting buses or hitting certain scenery elements. And again, it's more things to try and collect. You'll probably get a special car for getting all of them. This is like before open worlds. Open worlds love their collectibles. Whatever bloody game it is you're playing, if it has an open world, there will be multiple different things to go and collect. I like the way that this game did it, though. You didn't have to kind of go exploring as such and looking every single tiny dark place around a map to find one bloody figurine or whatever it is. I like Crackdowns with their bloody orbs, where there was, like 500, 750 of those bloody orbs that were dotted around the map in all of the hard-to-reach places. This is what you have to do, and there's all sorts of different things that you have to try and complete. It's just kind of, well, admittedly, oh no, we're not going that way, we're going down here. Admittedly, it's partially luck in that you have an opponent near you when a certain scenario, but there's also skill, because you've got to be able to put said opponent in the right, you know, in the right situation and so on. So I kind of like the way that this game did the collectibles. I'm doing terrible at driving around here, I will be honest. I'm doing really, really awfully. Also, I would like to point out something, and something I have just noticed. Okay, when I talked about Need for Speed, I criticised Need for Speed quite a lot with its stupid automatic counter-steering. Okay, and people's argument is Need for Speed is an arcade game. This is an arcade game. I can't show you because I can't spin the camera around, but watch the front wheels. This one here does not automatically counter-steer. Yes, this is the most arcadey racing game you will ever find, and this does not automatically counter-steer. If we go around here, yeah, I held it to the... To the right, sorry, I do know my left and right, and the steer and the wheels stayed pointing that direction. Whoa, car! I was going over the I was getting ready for the turn and I crashed. Yeah, the wheels stayed to the right. Yes, I know the handling is pure arcade on here, so I can get away with doing that around here. But look, the wheels respond to what I'm doing. That's how you do an arcade racing game, guys. Oh no, then I'm being silly and now I've all thrown myself out. That was just, yeah. It's quite difficult to emphasize points and race at the same time. Ooh, hello. I don't want to end up in the front of a motorhome. We're going to have a crash. Ooh, as we wiggle our way up a hill. The opponents have not really challenged me that much in this particular race at all. Like, I've crashed one of them off. The rest of them have just all buggered off. Right, that'd probably be why. How am I so far ahead? I've not really... Okay, I've had one crash on my own. We're bouncing off bridges and so on, and I seem to remember this game being meaner. Maybe I have just got a bit better at driving games. I seem to remember it wouldn't let me get away with kind of these pinging off the walls as much, and I thought it was going to throw me into a crash. Ooh, there we go, some air while drifting and everything. Yeah, I seem to remember it being meaner with the brushing of the wall and having your car get wrecked, but maybe that's just... Maybe I just drove a lot worse when I was a kid and playing this game. Who knows? This has got slightly higher top speed than the... That's quite interesting. Than the previous car. So there are differences in between the in the vehicles within the category. That was about 4 miles an hour faster on the boost than the previous one. I can't remember which one I used before. Was it the DX? Probably was. Right. There we go. FailRace is leading the table. Next race. Yes, let us see what we have got to be dealing with in the next challenge. Oh, also, while I think about it, when I finished off the crash mode, I was apparently supposed to unlock a special car. I think the reason why I didn't unlock the car is there was one crash event that I didn't... I got gold on, but I wasn't happy with the crash, so I went back to redo it, and then I didn't get gold on it again and got bored and moved on. So I think there was one crash event I still don't have gold on. Well, that was just the entire field went into the wall. So that's why I didn't get the special car when it came to finishing that. I'll have to go back and have a look, and can't remember which one it was now that I missed. So, woo, with the lane changes, you moron. No wonder you're going to end up getting wrecked. I could do with some boost. Any boost? No, we're just going to sit here at 150. Admittedly, 152 is still quite quick to be racing down the motorway. Oh, look at all of this traffic as well. Actually quite surprised. I don't remember there being so many cars on the road. It was quite a lot of traffic for me to end up in the back of on the motorways. Come on, cars, I need somebody to catch. Not quite like that. Okay, I mean, you made a pretty good point. I was going to say I need some cars to come catch up with me so I can put them into a wall and have some fun. And then they tried to put me in a wall. So, yeah. Be careful what you wish for, I guess, is the moral of the story there. Oh, this is not a lapped race by the looks of it. It is just a... point to point or whatever. Bye-bye. To space with the little one. Looks like kind of like a Civic Type R over there. Right. Ooh, through the gap there. Are we going to have any cars there? He's coming back to join in. They are quite aggressive, I will say that much. Boost slam from him, was it? Bus was trying to ruin the party. I think as well, by the looks of it, ooh, the colour above their position, will change. I think I might have actually got both of them there. Will change. So what you can do is if you kind of like get alongside them, you can force them into a wall, and they might not instantly crash, but if you can force them there long enough, you can cause damage to them, and then it'll only take a tiny hit to cause them to wreck, or you could just keep grinding them along the wall and it will eventually cause them to wreck. Oh, he got taken out by a truck. I initially got him into the truck, but the forward momentum of the truck got me as well. Tiny clip from that truck. But there we go. See, those two there are very, very, very red, so they've taken sizable damage, so it shouldn't take much. Okay, maybe it isn't that then. I can't remember what the colour means then. I thought that's what it was, because I thought when I was alongside whatever car it was. Maybe it's how angry they are with you! Ah. Forgot that if I was going to crash into the back of them, that was going to wreck me as well. Maybe it is how angry they are at you. Because I thought it was a damage thing, but perhaps not. Because, yeah, I was crashing one of them into a wall when it started changing colour. That would explain it, I guess. Did you just phase through a taxi? I saw that cheating. You've got the cheat codes over there. You definitely just phased through a taxi. Come back here. Come back here. You with the wall. There we go. Apparently that's a signature. Oh, yeah, because that was one of those location ones. So you hit them by the, I guess, a fishing area down there. Oh, stop playing Morse code with my bumper. Okay, we don't want any of that. Oh, I don't want to go swimming either. No, get away. You bully. I know I'll do exactly the same to you. Jesus, he's really going for me. You go in the wall. Damn it, it didn't work. Ah, now he's coming back. Go away. Finish. Boost. Hey, we're going to take victory. It was a hard-fought 4 victory. I've no idea where the rest of the field is either. There's one. They really did not having a good day. There we go. I'm guessing there's probably one more race. Hey, I got a new car. Yeah, I'm assuming it's a 3-race championship. What have we unlocked? Have we got anything interesting? Probably something into, I guess, muscle class? Oh, it's not going to show me. Okay, we have to wait till the end of the end of the championship. Okay, I can do that. Woo! And ping you into the wall. I've really been bullying that Civic lookalike. Not intentionally. It's just the way things have been. Whoa, he's crashed himself off the back of my car, which is okay. And you can go in. Oh, I was hoping I could push him into that. Oh, no. Okay, no, we're fine. We're fine. Invisible wall saved us. Well, not really invisible wall. Kind of big glowy yellow arrow saved us. I can work with that. And around the outside of you. Oh, I remember that section. I remember that section from the PSP version of the game. That particular corner. Yeah, I had Burnout 3 on Xbox. I also had the PSP version of this game as well, and they were pretty much, they were called slightly different things, but they worked pretty much in the same way. I can't remember if the PSP version had a crash mode. I don't remember ever playing a crash mode on the PSP, so it might not have done. Oh, arse. Yeah. When you get hit by a vehicle, you momentarily lose a little bit of control. So otherwise, it'd be far too easy to never get taken out by the AI. So when you like take a big shunt like that, as I fired his car across, you lose a momentary control, and that was one of those moments where I'd lost it, and I couldn't do anything to avoid ending up in the wall. Because if you didn't have that happen, then you would never get taken down by the AIs, because, well, they're like, that is a perfect example. The nudge has forced me to go to the right. I tried to counter that, but it don't do anything for a split second. So yeah, it's the way Burnout works, and it works very, very well for fun. I misjudged that speed all completely there. That was my terrible, terrible driving. I do apologize. I thought the tram was going a lot quicker than it was, and I didn't really want to have to kind of lift and brake at all. So yeah, I kind of went for it, and it wasn't going as fast as I expected. Oh well. Oh no, no, bad things. Bad things are happening. No, we're good. 12 seconds behind the leader. Right, how long will it take to catch up? Rubber band AI, please come back to me. Or just don't bring the guys behind forwards. Okay, bring the leaders back, and the guys behind can, well, they can come with me if they want. Aha, there we go. Yeah, didn't take too long, did it? Probably took me less than 12 seconds to catch up to them. Right, you can go to space over there with you, and Civic, you can go that way as well. damn it, he didn't crash. Now he's going to be angry at me, and now he's going to try and get revenge. I don't know where he is, but he probably will. Oh, there he is. Hey. I quite like this system, actually, because, yeah, now I'm experiencing it. It definitely seems like it's an anger system. Like, the early cars, I was going around the outside of them. They had no issues whatsoever with me. It's actually a pretty good system, because it means if you want to drive carefully, if you want to sort of race properly and not get caught or not crash off the AI to win, they're not going to do the same to you. So if you want to race cleanly, you can. If you want to have fun and make the cars go to space, you can as well, but beware, they will do the same to you. Oi! There we go, back across. We will carry on this little show. That is a really, really good system. I don't remember having that. I probably never really paid enough attention to it when I was playing this game as a child, but that is a seriously good system, especially for a game like this, where, you know, a lot of the fun is just causing mayhem. That works super, super well. Lots of modern games could learn from games like this. It's such a fantastic, fantastic experience playing Burnout again. And of course, the cars are always great fun to drive. As I said, yeah, it does feel a little bit heavier than the cars from Paradise. They feel perhaps sluggish is a bit, would be very unfair to them. But yeah, they don't quite change direction. Like, as you're transitioning drifts from corner to corner, they feel a little bit heavier. But it's not by too much, and they're still great fun cars to sort of chuck around. And so on, right, we are around the final corner. Glad there are no RC hidden bits of AI traffic around there. And we will take victory. Please crash, please crash. You cheating bugger. Where is the fun in that? I don't get to watch you plow into a truck. God damn it. You crash, come on. Nope, they got the cheat codes on. God damn it. Either way, I will take the... I'm hoping... Ah, yes, it is indeed. It is the championship complete. I will take the victory, and we have got three more cars unlocked. All right, let us see what we've got. Yay! Muscle cars. Always. I'm not sure that they're... Well, one of them's muscle car, that's for sure. I don't know about the rest of them. That's... one of them looks distinctly like a supercar to me. But never mind. Cool. There we go. Yeah, that was some of the racing, some of the road rage events. It's great fun. Burnout 3 is fantastic, fantastic fun. Yay, muscle. I guess I've just unlocked the basic muscle cars. Maybe they don't come automatically then. We have got... That looks distinctly like a Skyline to me. I'm not sure I would call that a muscle car. But hasn't that got like a fake Nismo sticker on the side of it? Oh, Mizzo. No, I'm not quite... That should be a... Never mind. Never mind, it's Burnout. And that's definitely a Ford GT. Or it's more like a GT40, actually. Well, there we go. Ah, dear. Yeah, Burnout is still exquisite fun. Cars drive really well. The takedowns are awesome, as expected, really. Oh, we've unlocked another car for doing 30 takedowns. We've unlocked... Oh, it's like the Assassin version or whatever. Ah, look at that. I'm remembering. Yeah, it is great fun racing on this game. There's lots of cool features that I don't remember, and especially with that AI aggression thing. I think that's fantastic for this. Anyway, that is going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time. Goodbye.